Thank you. All right, all right. Good evening, everybody. Good afternoon. Hope you're all doing well. Welcome to the stream. Welcome, Bruno. Hope you're doing well, brother. Good to see you. Good to see you. John, welcome to the chat. And Wing 42, of course, welcome. I'm glad you've got absolute faith in me. Although we are going to be flying the RIP variant today, so I think that's easily possible. Dave, good evening. Welcome to the stream. Good to see you, brother. Hope you're doing well. Let me just see if I've actually responded to your message. Yeah, Dave, self-loading cargo, it should install just like any other application on your computer. So it should leave a shortcut in your start menu. And I think you can choose to do one on your desktop as well. Do this thing. Ian, welcome to the chat. I hope you're doing well. Good to see you. Good to see you. Yeah, Steve, say hello in the chat. Get that shout out. Ramsey, welcome. Good afternoon. I hope you're doing well, brother. Good to see you. All right, then, guys. Something a bit different today. Taking a break from the old airliners, and we're going to be flying something a bit special. We are we're going to be flying the Blériot 11, and let's have a quick look. So here we are. Here is the absolutely beautiful machine that we're going to be flying today. And yeah, it's really cool. So I'll just give you a very, very quick introduction for those of you who have not seen this before on stream. We have flown it a few times, but so you may not be familiar with this. This is a payware add-on for Microsoft Flight Simulator by a company named Wing 42. And they've pretty faithfully recreated this aircraft. And it's absolutely amazing. It's so much fun to fly. It's difficult, but it's a lot of fun. And it's just a whole other world from any other aircraft you've ever flown before. It's a lot of fun. Yeah, I can't really say you know how much fun it is to fly. It's especially good for VFR if you're willing to put up with the fact that you've got to pretty much manually fly and correct almost constantly. But it's very, very cool for VFR because it flies so ridiculously slow. Where's my mustache? Unfortunately, I have to admit, I'm facially hair challenged. So I probably couldn't grow a mustache if I even tried. Check the thumbnail of the video. There's your mustache. Good evening, Leon. Welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Good to see you, brother. Good to see you. So this aircraft in Microsoft Flight Simulator, it actually comes with three variants. So you've got you've got three variants. So you've got the Anzani and the Anzani RIP edition. These are sort of the early kind of Blériot machines, if you like, and I believe this was the one that they used to fly across the channel. And yeah, it's as you can see, 32 knots cruise speed. It's incredibly slow and quite underpowered, as you will see once we get underway here. And then you've got the Gnome variant, which is it's a little bit more powerful. It definitely can get a bit more altitude than these two. And it's a little bit more forgiving. I think this was the one that was most commonly used later on. And these two, like I say, these are the earlier models. And there's two versions of this. So the first version, the straight up Anzani, is it's obviously they both look pretty much identical. But the Anzani is just a little bit more forgiving. It has sort of rudder control on the ground, so you can sort of roughly taxi it. But this is basically your true to life version. So there's no, you know, you can't turn it on the ground. And I believe the flight model is tweaked to be, you know, a little bit more as it would be in the real world, which is pretty rough, let's say. You'll see what I mean. Alistair, good afternoon or good evening. Welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Good evening, Frederick, as well. Welcome to the chat. Thank you very much. Yeah, you should enjoy this. This is going to be a lot of fun. This is going to be a lot of fun. Now that we've got the White Cliffs of Dover in Microsoft Flight Simulator, it should be really cool, actually, this, I think. Evening, Ian. Welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Does it have an MCDU? yeah, I'll leave that up to you to decide. If you just take a quick look at the aircraft. Zach, good evening. Welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Good to see you. All right. Okay. So that's the three variants sort of introduced. We're going to be using the RIP edition of the Anzani today. We're going to make this as faithful to the original trip as possible. And yeah, we're going to add in some sort of custom weather and we're going to use the exact sort of, well, not exact timings, but we're going to use the same sort of times that this original flight was conducted under. And as a result, yeah, it should be very, very interesting. It is indeed, yeah, Mike. It is actual real fly-by-wire. the Model T. I think no VATSIM today. Well, I mean, looking inside here, Unfortunately, this thing doesn't have a radio. Well, very little by the ways of any form of electronics, so yeah, I don't think you're gonna be on VATSIM today. Alright, cool. So let's get spawned in then and we'll get set up. We're gonna be flying basically from Calais to Dover. I'll give you guys a very, very quick sort of overview of the routing and the original routing that was taken. So if I just bring up the old the fuzz pad real quick. So basically we are going to be, bear me one second here, just doing something in the background. I've just realized I'm going to set my parking brake before I forget, because I don't have that bound at the moment. Right. Okay. But I'm going to get us in position in the background here whilst we have a look at this. So this is the routing, the original routing that was taken. This is in the manual that comes with the aircraft. Just got a little bit of information here about it, but basically, as you can see, we're going to be taken off from Calais, the small village name of Barrax, and I'm going to find us a nice little field just to the southwest side of Barrax here, and we're going to take off from there. Obviously, there was no airports in 1909. So we're going to be taking off in a humble field, and we're going to be flying across the channel. The aim is to get more or less a straight course from Barrax over to Dover. Oh no, what's happening in the background? Right. Okay, so we're going to be flying, like I say, from Barrax to Dover. The original flight landed just by Dover Castle. Now, unfortunately, that area where the original landing site was is actually a wooded area now, so we can't really land there. So we're going to try and find a place to land close by. Obviously, you know, some kind of field close by. I have scouted it out and there are a few spots that we could land at, so I'm sure we'll find somewhere to land. It's quite nice and flat as long as you go sort of inland a bit, so we should be good. And this was the original sort of, the routing is you know, it's intended to be a straight line, but what happened was, you know, in the actual flight, Blurio got blown off course a little bit. I believe what happened was he actually flew into a cloud, and he actually got blown by the wind and turned around, and he ended up doing this sort of wide course. So I mean, obviously we're not using any avionics, any kind of instruments really. This doesn't have any instruments in it, so anything could happen, really. We're going to try and simulate some of these conditions that were similar to on the day. So let's see. I'm just going to get us in a nice little spot here, and then we'll switch on over, and you guys can join me in the aircraft. Alright, just ignore the chat messages just coming up on Twitch. We're just I'm just trying to slew the aircraft into a field, and then we'll get underway here, guys. All right. So, yeah, I hope that's a nice bit of trivia for you guys. It should be pretty fun. I'm really, really looking forward to this, to be honest. It's, I've been planning it sort of for the last few days, and it should be a lot of fun. I've got these other two graphics as well, which kind of just show a little bit of information on the routing. Like I said, it gets blown off course here. The graphic's not too high resolution, but you can kind of see it's got the takeoff time and stuff here as well. So that's not handy to have, so we can actually use that to set the flight up. So I'm just going to verify that we're in the right place here on the map, and then we will switch over and get on the way here. Alright, so let me just quickly Google. I may have spelled that wrong. Here we are. So I believe Barracks is sort of in this area, I think. We're about here, so I think we are good. Right, cool. Let's switch on back over then, and we'll see about getting this thing fired up. Yeah, I think we're in pretty much the right place. I think we are. I think it's gonna do it. I think it's gonna work. That sim is pointless when if there's no radio transponder. Unfortunately, that sim doesn't recognize hand waving. Yeah, only if. And yes, for the channel flight, a buddy was waving a French flag at the coast. Awesome. We unfortunately don't have anyone waving the French flag. Someone needs to add that as a scenery, I think. Better pray for no winds. You'll get there sometime tomorrow. Third year from the 1900s. What about the green patch to the left? I think I'm good with this field, actually. This is a nice long field. This has been hand-selected by myself. Obviously, the coastline is up here behind us. And, we're basically going to want to sort of fly in that general direction. So, yeah, I'm not going to use... Sim toolkit or anything. I'm not going to use anything to track my location or whereabouts on the flight. I'm literally just going to do this completely, as it would have been done on the day. Yes, good tip, Wing 42. Definitely checking my fuel tank before we go. I'm just going to crank this up all the way to full because I know there has been some adjustments made to the. To the fuel consumption, and I don't want to risk running out here. So we'll crank it up to full. Hopefully we don't get blown off too far, of course. So let's see if we can recreate some of this some of these conditions then. So the date the flight was taken was on the 25th of July 1909. Now unfortunately I did try this the other day. Unfortunately you can't wind the year all the way back to 1909. The earliest you can go is 1990. So we'll just go with 1990. We'll go with 1999. So at least it's, it's an equal amount of, equal amount of tens away. So that makes sense, I suppose. Let's do 1999. And then we'll put it to July the 25th. And then we're going to add in some weather conditions here. Now, I'm not going to go too crazy with this because I don't want to make it impossible. But what I'm going to do is let's add a little bit of wind in. Let's add it in around just above ground level. around here. And it would have been a southwesterly wind on the day, so we'll add that in about like that. The winds, I believe, were quite light. However, I think as the flight progressed, it did actually get a bit windier. Now, unfortunately, there's no way we can really simulate that. But I think what we might just do is we'll put in a long frequency on the gusts and then make the gusts like, I don't know, maybe like 150% or something like that, 160. And that might, you know, add a bit to it, maybe. We'll see. And then we're going to add in a few clouds, not many like, because it wasn't particularly bad weather on the day, as far as I'm aware. So we'll add quite a big scatter in the clouds, but we're going to put these relatively low, because if he ran into clouds on the day, they must have been quite low, to be fair, because this thing doesn't fly at a high altitude, really. So we'll put them in quite low, maybe not that many, just a few like that. I think that might work quite well. Maybe a few more than that, actually. Not like crazy thunderstorm crowds or anything, just something a little bit... Wait, where have they all gone now? There we go. Oh, I like that. That looks pretty good, actually. I think that looks fairly reasonable. Maybe if we drop the altitude down even more. Like, they're still not down where we are, but I don't know. Let's just put it at zero. Maybe it gives us... Let's put it at maybe 100. Let's put it at 100. All right, cool. And then we don't need to put any clouds any much higher than that, because, yeah, it's really just not going to make a difference, because we won't be getting up that high. All right. I think we're about good to get going then, guys. Who is ready for this thing? Let's set the time as well. So the time he took off was, in fact, pretty early morning. It was 4:41, so let's set it right here. We'll set it to 4:40 there on the UTC time. In fact, it'll have been... obviously been local time, won't it, I suppose? Or will it have been UTC time they'll be using on here? I'm not actually sure. It's if we set it to local time, it's going to be near impossible. It's going to be extremely impossible, because it's going to be dark. Let's see, 4:41, it takes... possibly about 45 minutes or so. 5:30, and it's still dark. So, yeah, I think we set it to UTC time. I don't know if anyone in the chat has any advice on that one. Took off just after dawn. Yeah, I mean, that makes sense. So, yeah, it must have been Zulu time then, not local. All right. In fact, I'm not sure why this is showing 6:35, because I would think that Calais is on the same time zone as us, isn't it? In the UK. So, yeah, let's do it like that. So that will do it. Great stuff. Hey, yo, holy crap. Holy crap. Lightzilla, welcome to the chat. Thank you very much for the raid over on Twitch. Much appreciated, brother. I hope you had a good stream. Chat just exploded there for a second with Flightzilla emotes. Welcome to the chat, guys. Hope you're doing well. Jeff Boy, thank you very much. Flightzilla, of course. Bailey Taylor, Veto Potato, and Airspeed Live. Thank you, guys, for the follows. Hope you're all well and having a fantastic evening, and welcome to the stream. Welcome. Thank you again, Flightzilla, for the raid. Much appreciated. you guys have popped in at absolutely the perfect time. We're just about to get underway in this absolute machine. Thank you very much, guys. Craig Lord and the Real Qubit, thank you very much for the follows. Much appreciated. Thank you very much. For those of you watching on Facebook, I know there's quite a few people watching on Facebook at the moment. We just got raided over on Twitch by Flightzilla. Anyone in Cali that can spill? We're going to get underway in a second, guys. I just wanted to say hello to the raiders. Thank you very much, buddy. Thanks, Flightzilla. Glad you're enjoying. You can't rush excellence, exactly. This is a fine flying machine. You can't rush this. Look at this guy in the cockpit right here. Just take a look. Take a look. Does he look like the kind of guy who is in a rush to you? Does he look in a rush? No. I didn't think so. All right. I'm doing very well. Thank you, Flightzilla. Yeah, I hope you are doing too, brother. Thank you very much, dude. All right. Okay. Without further ado, anyway, I feel like I'm holding the show up a little bit. Let's do this thing. All right. So let's get this thing started up. So, fairly straightforward startup process. Really, all we need to do, first of all, is jump in. Make sure the chocks are on, first of all, of course. Chocks are in, so we're looking good. Second of all, get the main fuel valve turned on. Pretty simple and straightforward. And then we jump on up to the magneto switch and turn that on as well. That's it. Crank the throttle up. Nice and high. Everybody hold tight. Get ready. Let's get this thing powered up. Oosh. There she goes. There she goes. What a boost. I love how it's like bobbing about as well. Like when you're sat in the cockpit here, like it's just like getting jostled a bit by the engine. Now, I want to show you guys just before we take off as well. Check out the detail inside this engine here. Like all like the little pistons lighting up. Pistons? There might be pistons lighting up like this. Yeah, it just looks really cool. Super nice detail on this. And I just need to turn my volume down a bit. That's a bit loud. All right, guys. Let's do this thing. I'm quite nervous, to be honest. This is quite a tough beast to fly. Ignore the landing rate. I'm not sure why that's popped up there. There we go. It's gone now. It is very nicely modeled, Flightzilla. Yeah, it's absolutely brilliant. Yeah, it is payware. Yeah, it's by a company called Wing 42. All right, guys. Let's do this thing. So, let's release them chocks. Crank up that throttle, and we are going. I've got no rudder control on the ground here, so we've just got to let it do its thing. Let's get that. Get that tail wheel off the ground. Oh, here she goes. And she's up. She's up. Chocks away. All right, there we go. We need to swing her around to the left anyway, so... I'm glad I'm being pushed around by the wind here. That's not me turning, by the way. Let's go, guys. Ready to turn left. Hope I know how to swim. Right, there we go. We're oriented correctly. I'm pretty sure this is where we need to go. I kind of looked on a map earlier on. I think we can use this lake here. This lake is kind of pointing towards Dover, so we're going to use that. Yeah, guys, this is quality for VFR, honestly. Like, if you can control it, like, because it goes so ridiculously slow, it's just perfect for VFR. Oh no, a bit of an over control there. Yeah, there's a flotation device just there in the back. I'm not gonna lie, it kind of looks like concrete, but that should keep me alive if I fall in the water, if I crash. Look at that climb rate, guys. Look at that climb rate. Look how high we are already. Not. Alright, let's see if I can get myself oriented properly here. Alright then, we're pointing in the right direction at least now. I'm gonna turn this I'm gonna turn the hand cam off, but obviously, guys, I'm gonna be manually controlling it the whole way. There's not too much to see except for the fact that I'm just frantically moving my joystick every second. Yeah, that's a good call, Bruno. Definitely use the sun. Alright then. Here we go, guys. We're about to reach the coast. There's no turning back from here. There's no turning back. It looks so far away. Dover looks... I can't even see... I don't know. Can we see Dover? Oh, you can just about see the land from here. Wish me luck, guys. Wish me luck. Bon voyage indeed, Zach. Thank you very much. Yeah, A-Speed Live. This would be crazy in real life. I'm not sure I would be overly excited about getting in this thing in real life. I mean, this hole in the bottom here isn't really going to meet that many health and safety standards, is it? I'm getting turned around here. Let me just see if I can correct this. Lewis had some worse weather when he took his trip. It must have been more hazy when he flew this. Yeah, unfortunately, I don't think there's any way of really making haze or fog in flight sim at the moment. Unless I can... Let's see. Maybe if I crank up the aerosol density, maybe? That's a bit hazier, right? That's quite a bit hazier, isn't it? Yeah, you can't see the land over there anymore. You sort of can, but it's definitely a lot hazier. I think I'm heading to Land's End. I hope not. Let's see. There's that lake. The sun's to our right. I think we need to be a little bit more to the right. Yeah, I suppose it doesn't go too high, but yeah, I mean, I think it's the problem is with this aircraft is that it's just so unpredictable and it's so easy to get just blown by the wind. I think very, very sadly, someone actually flew one of these things through the I think it was through the Alps where they flew it, and they flew successfully through, I believe it was, like I say, the Alps. And very, very tragically, after they'd made the trip and landed, their aircraft got blown over and they got crushed by it and died. So, yeah. It's not just the dangerous machine in the air. Battle roll time. Oh no. I mean, it would definitely be an experience for sure. If you were at like an air show and they could do like a small, I'm definitely going the wrong way now. I definitely need to be going more to the right. Yeah, I think if it was at an air show and you could sort of take it for a bit of a lap around the field, or maybe just the length of the field or something, that might be a bit more manageable, let's say. I'm going to have to turn the volume down just a touch here. It's quieter. Quite a loud machine that's sat in the cockpit. Just look at it. It's a beauty though, isn't it? It's funny, it's like the actual way it uses to roll is by warping the wings like this. As you can see, it's kind of moving a little bit just here. And I mean, it's actually incredibly ineffective. It's so difficult to actually get it to roll into a turn. You have to use a lot of rudder, a lot more rudder than on any other aircraft I've ever had to ever flown in flight sim. Right, there we go. I think we are. Oops. Oops. Nope. There we go. Yeah, I think we're looking. I think we're on course. Am I a fan of football? I mean, I don't dislike it. I just don't really follow it. Pilots must have flapped their arms to get more lift. I mean, it might work. It might work. This thing's so lightweight. You could get like a really big, like, I don't know, like a big sign or something, and just like waft it out the side. All right, I tell you what we'll do is, whilst we are in flight here, let's just put some other tunes on. All right, let's see. Have I missed any other messages here? It's quite hard to fly this thing and look at chat at the same time, because every time I look away, it turns away from me. So you guys are gonna have to be my eyes if I'm reading chat and I get turned around. I'm relying on you guys. Adam, good evening. Welcome to the chat, brother. Hope you do well. Oh, I keep pressing that on my joystick by accident. There we go. Oh, no, no. It's so easy to accidentally overturn. I'm so intrigued to see what my flight path is going to be like on this once we land. I've set Sim Toolkit Pro recording, so it's gonna map out our flight path. So that's going to be very interesting to look at. Sean, good afternoon. Hope you do well. Welcome to the chat. How high are the cliffs? Yeah, they're not too high, are they? I think we'll quite easily clear it in this thing. Oh dear, just look at it moving the wind. If I just hold my joystick to center here and not touch anything, you guys can see how much it just gets moved about. Oh no, hang on, what's happened? Oh, had a little hiccup from the sim. I think it's because my Xbox pad's just disconnected. There we go. Beautiful. No problem for a machine like this. A ceiling of a whopping 2,000 feet. Yeah, indeed. For those of you guys who don't know, in the Facebook chat, Wing42 is the developer of this add-on, this aircraft for Microsoft Flight Simulator. Highly recommend going to check out their products, their Facebook page, their website. They've got some really, really cool stuff on the way. And yeah, there's obviously this beauty as well, which is an absolute... It's got to be... up there with one of the best, most fun, enjoyable aircraft I've flown in Flight Sim 2020. And it's a very, very reasonable price as well, so highly, highly recommend you checking Wing 42 out. Bob, good evening. Welcome to the stream. Thank you very much, dude. Glad you're enjoying. Anyway, I was showing you guys how much it moves in the wind, wasn't I? Okay, so if I just let go of my joystick here, which is a scary prospect. Like, I'm not touching my joystick now. it just slowly starts to move itself towards the wind, basically. The wind's coming from down there to our left in the southeast. And we're totally turned around now. Holy crap. Look at all those clouds over there, actually. It looks like we might actually run into some clouds here on the way, guys. Kind of like, hopefully we... That would be quite cool if we do, actually, to be fair. That's actually what happened in the real flight, so... It's leaping the wind, yeah, it certainly is. Powered by a weed whacker engine. This is going to be interesting. We've got a fairly sizable cloud in front of us, actually. Let's see how far away we are now. Look at that. Yeah, dear. Oh. Oh. I do not want to put this thing in a spin, because if we go into a spin, I think we're pretty much done for. It's I've got all the damage on as well in Microsoft Flight Sim, so we can overstress this if we over control it. I know I have made that mistake in the past before. Just over controlling it and ending up breaking the thing. It's a fragile beast. Three-stroke, yeah, it's not a powerful engine at all. What is it? It's like 25 horsepower, this engine. It's originally meant for a motorbike in 1909, so it's, yeah. Oh, why do I keep doing that? Yeah, I definitely think we're off course a little bit here. I think we need to be going to the right of this big cloud that we see in front of us. Do I have a Discord? Yes, I do. On Twitch, you can go and you can type in !! Discord into the chat, and it should come up. Unfortunately, Discord's not too active at the moment. Because I'm trying to juggle all sorts of different bits and bats. I'm trying to get my Instagram going and trying to deal with my Facebook page as well. And Discord is just another thing that's just unfortunately not getting too much attention at the moment, but there is quite a few of us on there, and I do try to post in there when there's like flight sim updates and stuff like that. But yeah, you're more than welcome to drop by. I have done in the past as well some sort of private streams on there as well, where I've not been wanting to get on camera and whatnot for the stream, so I've just just done it on there. I need to get this thing heading to the right a bit more, for sure. It's really weird engine design too. There's only one push rod that operates intake and exhaust simultaneously. Must have been a leaky engine too. Yeah. I don't doubt that, honestly. It's it looks quite, I don't know what the word is. It just doesn't look overly suitable for the job, if I'm not gonna lie. What do I photograph? I'm an architectural photographer, so I photograph basically buildings, interiors, commercial spaces, that kind of thing. I also do quite a bit of landscape photography as well, although I've not really obviously had too much chance to really do that, considering the current climate. But yeah, that's what I photograph. Probably one of the best in that time. Probably. I suppose obviously they were making do with what they had available to them. And I definitely want to avoid this cloud. I keep going towards it. I can't seem to get myself away from it. I'm being sucked towards it like a black hole. Sounds good, Bailey. Yeah, that sounds really good. Just ping us a message whenever you're about, and that's cool, man. Lirio had a different engine on his initial design called a Derep, but it was too unreliable for his channel flight. That's fair. I mean, I suppose this one, at least, in my limited experience, seems to at least be somewhat reliable. Felix, good afternoon, brother. Hope you're doing well. Welcome to the chat. What is this aircraft? It is a Blériot 11. One of the first aircraft, basically to ever exist. And it was the first aircraft to cross the channel, the English Channel, which is what we're doing right now. We're probably about halfway across now. I can see the land over the other side. My fuel left. There isn't actually a way to tell how much fuel you have left. At least in this implementation. I mean, you've got this little oil pressure gauge here, which you can see sort of bubbles away. But I don't think it actually has any indication on how much fuel you've got left. You don't really know how much fuel you've got left, to be honest. You've just got to pray, hope and pray. I imagine in the original design you might have been able to maybe use some kind of dipstick somewhere wherever the fuel is loaded, which I imagine is here. Maybe, I don't know. Awesome, Bailey, nice. Well, thank you very much, guys, if you've joined over on the Discord. Appreciate that, thank you very much. I'm not sure why the alerts are muted from Facebook, but I think I've missed a few people, so Ted, Emily and Abdi Fatah, thank you very much for following over on Facebook. Much appreciated. I hope you're well and having a fantastic week. Welcome to the stream. Oh, there is. Oh, that's what that is. I was wondering what that was. Okay, so this is the fuel indication, and this is the fuel tank. Okay, got it. I'm used to the GNOME variant, which doesn't have the indicator. Okay, so it's not actually burning too much fuel then, although I did just see it go down, so let's hope everything still continues as planned. Look at that view right there. Imagine being sat in here and just seeing that. Oh dear. Let's stay away from this cloud though. Let's stay away from this cloud. Let's try and get that nose turned into this bank. I'm giving it almost constant right bank and right rudder at the moment. There we go. Yeah, just look at this thing as well, like, look at the flight controls. Incredible. And I was reading in the manual as well, this thing apparently was an absolute, it required a lot of strength just to move this. So I can only imagine, like, I mean, flying it in a sim is probably quite far away from how it actually felt to fly in real life. Flightzilla, thank you very much for dropping by, brother. Thank you very much for the raid. Much appreciated. Enjoy the rest of your evening. And yeah, dude, I'll catch you soon. Take it easy, man. Yeah, take it easy, man. I will have to pop in and catch your stream at some point soon. There's also no trim, so you're constantly fighting the tail heaviness. Yeah, exactly. I can relate. Now then, we can see the coastline in front of us. I'm not seeing the white cliffs of Dover, though. Not just yet. Sounds as clingy as my car does at the moment. Pray you make it, bro. Yeah, thank you very much, dude. Damn, your cow must be having some serious issues if it sounds like this, I'm not going to lie. But still, that's 97 followers, nearly 100. I will go over and drop you a follow, dude. No problem at all. Oh, you got 250, damn. Oh, we got me to 150, holy crap. Amazing. Well, thank you very much for all the love, guys, over on Twitch. Appreciate it. Thank you. Okay, I feel like we've not gone too far off course here. I think we're doing okay. But I can't see the cliffs just yet. Maybe it's behind this cloud? Oh, maybe it's here. And it's just not rendered in. I don't know. Let's see. Maybe when we get a bit closer, we'll be able to see. I'm in the cockpit, if you can call it that. Yes, this is it is the cockpit, yeah. Your car probably has more than 25 HP even with the blown head gasket. Yeah, probably. I hope that for your sake this is the RIP edition. Yes, it is, dude. Wouldn't have it any other way. Bailey, thank you very much. Glad you're enjoying. Thank you. We're probably just over halfway there, I imagine. At this point, if you look behind us, the French coast is quite a fairly distant memory. Meso, welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Good to see you. Do you have any gauges or anything? Alt or speed? No. I mean, you've got a fuel gauge right here, and then like an oil pressure gauge right here. That's it. Let me just see if I can adjust this light real quick. Making my face like super red. There we go, that's a bit better. Don, thank you very much for the share over on Facebook. Much appreciated. Thank you. How has my day been today? It's been decent, thank you. Yeah, it's been quite a chilled Sunday. Just the usual, you know, just potting about the house. Doing, you know, chores, washing up. Very exciting life, Ellie. And played a bunch of Rocket League with my brother. Excuse me, which was it's always fun. But yeah, it's been decent. Thank you. Yeah, how's your day been, Bailey? And thank you very much for hosting me as well. Much appreciated. Thank you. People who fly for leisure will never understand how we got here today. Yeah, this is a whole other world, isn't it, really? Oh, you played Rocket League as well, nice. We might have, what game mode were you playing? Were you playing, we mostly play competitive duos. Thing is, despite the simplicity, she is extremely difficult to fly. You'll really learn about aerodynamic forces when jumping into this cockpit. Yeah, I agree. I agree completely. Yeah, it's not a walk in the park. Twos and threes, nice. Maybe we played you. gold three. We're kind of hovering around gold three at the moment. Can't seem to break it, to be honest with you. We've been playing a bit of hoops in competitive as well, which is quite fun. Whoa, okay, we're getting blown. Look, I wasn't holding onto the stick there, and we just got gusted. I think we're doing good though, guys. Like, I think we've done pretty well. We're in platinum threes, plat three and threes, and diamond one and twos. Okay, so we probably didn't go against you then. You would probably have probably kicked our ass. I think just in front of us, that's the Cliffs of Dover. I just don't think it's properly rendered in yet. Although I feel like you should probably be able to, it should probably render in by now. Or maybe we're a lot further away than we think. Yes, mate, by all means, Bailey, you'd probably be carrying me pretty hard, though, I'm not going to lie. Just drop us a message on Discord, dude. Angle attack is huge because of the ridiculous wing shape. Yeah, it's quite the thing, this wing. Let's even get... There we go. Just look at the shape. Look at the size. It's really a thing. Yeah. Right, I let go of the stick and we just get totally turned around. Let's rectify this situation. Yeah, I'm looking forward to landing this. It's a lot of fun to land this. A lot of fun indeed. I have a new, we have a replay feature now as well, that we can use, so we'll be able to watch the landing back, which should be quite cool. Yeah, mate, Bailey, by all means, drop us a message on Discord, dude. I think we need all the help we can get. Nearly scored a double flip reset the other day. Nice, dude, nice. I struggle with even doing a single flip reset, so. The sun is supposed to be on your starboard wingtip. Yeah. I mean, it's there or thereabouts. I reckon you could pull off a loopy loop. I mean, we could potentially try it. We could potentially try it after we've at least landed once. It could be worth a shot. Asa, good evening. Welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Good to see you. All right, I think that's the cliffs in front of us, guys, but it's just not rendered in properly at the moment. Dave, good evening. I hope you're doing well. Good to see you in the chat. I hope you're doing well indeed. Oh, no. Oh. Whew. I looked away for a second there and it nearly went pear-shaped. Is there any runway? No, we're going to be landing in the traditional way in a field. I feel like there weren't too many airports back in 1909, so we're going to do it the 1909 way. The only thing you struggle with is a musty flick quite hard. I'm not going to lie, I'm not sure what a musty flick is. I'm sure we're going to see the Isle of Wight. He had no faith in me, dude. All right, it might be a good time to actually start losing a bit of this altitude, to be honest. So let's start doing that. So really, there's only one way to lose altitude in this. I mean, I can pull back the throttle a little bit. There we go. So I've pulled the throttle back a tiny, tiny touch there. Don't know if you guys can hear the different sort of sound of the engine. But the way I believe it was done is basically just to toggle the magnetos on and off and just stop the engine for a moment and then put it back on. So that's the way we're going to do it. So basically just a case of... and making sure I don't leave the engine off too long, otherwise it's just going to cut out and we'll just become a glider. So... and it is a lot harder in this, actually. I have done this before in the Gnome variant, which I think I kind of got the hang of, but I was playing around with this over the weekend and I feel like it's a lot less, it's got a lot of a much lower tolerance to leaving it off for too long. Oh, are the cliffs going to render in yet? It looks like they're starting to form a rough shape. It's kind of a shame we can't see them from up here, to be honest. That would be quite a nice sight. The Neo is somewhere above us at flight level 320 on autopilot on the way to Dublin. It must be nice having a cockpit with nice air conditioning. Oh, I know this is Dover because I can see obviously the port here and then there's the castle just up there. So we are in the right spot. Just for some reason, the cliffs aren't really rendering in. Because in the UK update, they did add in the cliffs like fully 3D modeled, but for some reason it's just not. Maybe it's because we're a little bit too high, maybe. I don't know. We'll see. They seem to be taking a bit of a shape as we get closer, though. As we descend a bit here. You've got all the air conditioning you need right now. This is very true. Yes, we're not really struggling for airflow right here. I'm so scared when I turn the engine off for a second there. I just don't want it to cut out on us. It makes your landing spot so much more limited. I'm going to try and fly a little bit parallel to the cliffs here just for a short while. Because I kind of want to see them render in, but I don't know if we're going to actually pass them before. Before they actually render in. We have actually got some pretty good altitude here, actually, to be fair. I think this is the highest I've been in the Anzani. Bailey, if you shoot us a message on Discord, I'll let you know when I'm about. I generally don't play a lot of Rocket League during the day and the week. But yeah, just shoot us a message and whenever you're on, and I may or may not be on at that moment. Sorry, I can't be more specific. Come on, Cliffs, show yourselves. Imagine how scared he was. Yeah, I mean, yeah, it is probably a fairly scary experience being in this aircraft. There they are. Beautiful. Love to see it. Love to see it. There's the cliffs. Beautiful. Very nice. Usually I like to take a lot of screenshots in this thing, but unfortunately this one is just, it's just not suitable for taking your hands off the joystick for any amount of time. So then guys, let's see if we can find somewhere to land then. So fortunately for us, there's plenty of fields around here. So I think I'm just going to start descending and just try and aim for one. So over here to our left, I believe this is the castle, and I believe where the original flight landed, or should I say crash landed, was kind of in this area just to the left. So we'll try and get relatively close to there, but I mean, this little strip right here looks quite enticing, potentially. But I don't know if we're going to get down there in time, to be quite honest. We could probably do a turn around as we fly over and come back on ourselves. I'm just very wary of turning with this thing at low altitudes, because it just seems to fall quite drastically when you make any sort of decent turn. Yo, Philbert Flies in the chat. Thank you very much for the follow, brother. Hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome. Different, yeah, just a little bit different to normal, this Dave. Yeah, I'm doing very well, Phil, but thank you very much for asking. How are you doing? Yeah, I'm very aware of who Philbert Flies is. I think I watch probably more of his videos than any other YouTuber, to be honest. Absolutely love Philbert's reviews on the scenery and whatnot. I've based many of my purchasing decisions on his reviews of airports and whatnot. Absolutely love to hear his insightful analysis on ground textures. Well, you've tuned in at an absolutely fantastic time, Philbert. We are just coming down for a landing after doing a channel crossing in the Blériot 11. So this could be quite amusing or quite amazing. I don't know. We're about to find out. Looks like it's built to crash. Yeah, I mean, it definitely doesn't look like the safest thing in the world, but we'll see how we get on. So I'm thinking, I might try and swing us round this way and try and land. Actually, saying that, the wind is kind of coming from this way, so it might be good to maybe, I don't know, if we turned around and maybe landed somewhere over here. That area looks kind of decent. I suppose here isn't too bad. It's a nice long field, and it's at least it's sort of got a little bit of a headwind component there. Let's see. So you just finished playing Quagmire. I've never heard of that. How is it? Is it good? Flightzilla's one away from 100. Well, I just dropped him a follow a little bit, about 5 minutes ago or so. So hopefully that's ticked him over. Okay, we're definitely getting jostled about a little bit as we come in closer to the ground here. So I'm still debating which field I should go for, guys. I'm still debating. I can't decide. Do we swing around and try for this one, or do we go for something that might be a little bit more into the wind? Look at that view though. I love looking through this view. Amazing. Yeah, I mean, it does fly very slow, so I suppose it doesn't roll for a long time as long as you're not on a hill. One thing is, I don't think I've mentioned in this stream just yet, is that this thing, it has no brakes. So there's also that to bear in mind. Land at Gatwick. We'll be landing at Gatwick today. No, we're doing it the 1909 way today. So we're landing in a field, as would have been done back then. All right, I still need to lose a bit of altitude here, so we'll carry on toggling the. I think I'm going to try for this field, honestly. I think we're a little bit slim pickings if we go in front of us, and we'll have to do quite a big loop around if we don't go for this field, I think. So let's swing ourselves to the right. Oh no, I've messed up, guys. Oh no, this is a big problem. Oh no. Oh no, that is a big F. I've left the magneto off for too long. Oh no, I was too busy trying to explain to everybody where, okay. Well, at least we don't have an issue with losing altitude now. We're just gonna fall out the sky. All right, where are we gonna go then? I mean, luckily we're in quite an area with a lot of quite large fields, so I don't think it's going to be wise to try and make a big turn for this field over here right now because we're just going to lose too much altitude. So I think we're going to have to just kind of just go nice and slow here and try and just put it somewhere. Oh no. Oh dear. You can see the propeller just slowing down. I think to our right, though, I think we're quite lucky because there's quite a few nice big flat fields to our right. We're going to be landing with a little bit of a tailwind, but I think we should be okay. I hope. I believe when this flight was actually originally conducted, he did actually have to cut the engine towards the end anyway, so I mean, let's just pretend we're doing this for realism aspect, for realism purposes. Oh dear, we're getting incredibly low now. We're probably gonna just skim these trees here to our right, and I'm gonna aim for that field. All right, are we ready, guys? Oh, please don't hit this tree. Oof. All right, here we go. Giving it a bit of a flare. Oh, there we go, we're down. Oh. Stay upright. No. Okay. Okay, we're down. Oh, God. Oh. Well. Oh, we landed. Like butter, guys. Like butter. Oh my lord. Let's have a look at the state of this. Oh dear. Oh dear. That's got to be a screenshot right there. Oh dear, oh dear. I honestly thought it was going quite well until that happened. I mean, I'm fairly pleased with that. I'm fairly pleased. He crashed as well. Yeah, exactly, Mike. Exactly. He crashed as well. This is for historic accuracy, guys. For historic accuracy. Note to self, tailwind is a big no-no. Yeah, I kind of learned my lesson there, but I'm not sure I had too many choices, unfortunately. All right, guys, that was good fun. Let's watch a little bit of a replay real quick. So, let's see. I stopped recording. And what we should be able to do now is, if I hit replay, this is courtesy. In fact, it was in fact Philbert Flies in the Twitch chat who made me aware of this this application, this flight recorder. And yeah, it's brilliant. We can actually go in now and watch it back as we come in, which is just brilliant. You think he left? Yeah, after that landing, I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised anyone's still here, to be honest. I should have definitely given it a bit more backwards pressure on the elevator. as I came in there. I think you meant flights are like, okay, fair enough. Yeah, anyway, so we can check out this this replay. It's just so good that we've got this now. Let's see if we can get a nice little camera angle here. Oh yes, there we go. Right, let's get it a little bit closer to where we landed. Unfortunately, it doesn't quite pick up the engine properly yet. I think they don't have a proper way of actually detecting whether the engine's running or not. So the engine sort of state in the replay will just be as it was when you landed, which obviously it was stopped for us. Let's have a quick look at this landing then. So we've got, like I said, we've got Dover Castle just over there. And then I believe where Blurio originally landed was just next to it in one of these fields right here, which are now covered by trees, hence why we weren't landing there. This was the strip that we were kind of hoping for originally. And then I did a boo-boo. And left the magnetos off for just a bit too long there. You made it down. That's a big success in this aircraft. Yeah. I mean, yeah, we didn't like destroy the aircraft or anything. We have, you know, I have damage turned on in Microsoft Flight Sim. So we clearly didn't land with enough of an impact to actually break the aircraft fully, at least. So, I mean, I'll take that. You know, I'll take that. All right, let's. So it was about here where I lost the engine. Because you can kind of see on the flight recorder, you can see our elevation profile just starts dropping off a lot quicker just here. So if we fast forward a bit to as we come a bit closer in here. Let's see how this looks. Oh dear, why did nobody warn me about the tailwind? I think that might be the... No, actually, I've definitely crashed this before. I was about to tell a lie. I've definitely crashed this before. I think that might be the first time I've flipped it, though. All right, let's see how close we were to these trees as we go over. Oh! I think we must have just clipped a couple of branches there. All right, here we go. Here's the landing. Flaring a little bit there and down. That was actually okay. Oh no, and you can see the back wheel coming up. And yeah, we went down a little bit. Oh dear. Oh. Yeah, we went down a little bit of a hill, didn't we? So that must have not helped. All right, let's just go back a little bit further. Oh, and see, I thought I had it stable there. I thought we were about to stop, and then there we go. Oh dear, wounded. I was robbed, yeah, indeed, Phil, but I'm gonna take that. I agree. What I do want to show you guys though is the incredible effects on this as you touch down here. So if we go to the sort of the prop cam, if you like, let's just put this over. Yeah, we'll put it about here. And if you guys just look at the struts here as it touches down, look at that. Beautiful. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. Oh dear, we're going into the ground. Perfection, indeed. I agree. And there we are. And there we are. This is our final resting place now. We're just gonna sit here for a bit. All right. Yeah, let's see our flight path now. Oh, I don't think it's recorded properly, actually. Let's see. And it seems like it's just disappeared off the map. On Sim Toolkit Pro, so it had the path here before, but it just seems to have disappeared. That's a bit unfortunate. What else? Would there have been another app recording? No, unfortunately I didn't have anything else open. Oh, that's a shame. No, it doesn't appear to have... Wait, let me just try and see if I go... No, I don't think it's going to work. Don't know if this is just going to trigger it to save the... No, it's not. Oh, that's a shame. You can't see our flight path. I mean, that would have been quite amusing to look at, I'm not going to lie, but that's a shame. Never mind. Never mind, that was fun indeed. Okie dokie, Philbert, take it easy. Well, glad to have you anyway. Enjoy the rest of the evening and I'll catch you soon. Thanks for tuning in. That wasn't fun indeed, yes, it was. Yeah, very, very enjoyable. Very, very enjoyable. All right, so, I mean, it is a relatively short flight, that, although it's quite, I'm not going to lie, it's quite taxing. So I was thinking of maybe flying back, potentially. Maybe. Or flying somewhere else close by in the UK in this thing. Maybe, and see if we can pull off maybe a little bit less of a spectacular landing. However, first of all, let's see. Oh, I never noticed that. The actual, the model actually moves when you move the control surfaces. That's, I didn't notice that before. That's very cool. So let's just zoom this out. Yeah, I am, oh, let's just go about there. That's a screenshot and a half. Right, I'm just going to, I'm just nipping to the toilet real quick and I'll be back and we'll take it from there. All right. Yeah, it's crashing is not generally something that happens on this stream, but this is a little bit of an exceptional circumstance, let's say. It's not the usual type of aircraft that we're flying on this on the channel. I mean, Boggrass, yeah, it could well have been Boggrass. I mean, I'm going to take any reason I can get for it flipping over and it not being my fault. I tell you what I did want to try, though, real quick, just before we move on here, is just go back to the replay real quick. And I want to just try using the drone camera here to try and do a bit of like a follow type cam. So, where's she gone? There she is. Now, I think it's targeting, it's quite difficult to get it to actually target the right spot, but look at her go. Absolute machine. Right, let's see. Right, now if I go to, there we go. I mean, that's not too bad, but it's so difficult to actually get it to sort of target the right spot. It's very strange. Let's go, where did we land? Over in this field over here. Just right the camera. And what we can do is we can just zoom in a little bit and give it a bit of a click. Oh no, that's not working, is it? Oh. I got it to work quite well last night, but it just doesn't seem to want to work now. Oh well, we'll just do it manually. Here she comes. Oh no, he looks so worried. Oh. Oh, and there she goes. I like how it sort of almost self-righted itself after going fully over. Oh dear me. Alright, Bailey, dude, no worries at all. Thank you very much for tuning in anyway. Much appreciated, man. Thank you very much for the love. Alright, guys, so yeah. Do we try again? Let me have a quick look on the map here. Where else could we go? I think probably flying back is gonna be the one to do. Alright, so a plane isn't totally destroyed, so I'm pretty sure we can still use it. So let's get it on slew mode and just get ourselves properly oriented here. So that's going to be roughly to the east. So the winds were, what, southwesterly? So I think we want to be sort of roughly in this direction here. So I think that should do. This would be a nice little takeoff strip for us. Oh. There we go. Let's make sure the chocks are in place so we don't roll away. Bailey, thank you very much for dropping by. Yeah, lovely to have you, and I'll catch you soon. All right, guys, I think I'm ready to give it another go. I would like to try and get a more satisfying landing, because this is such a satisfying thing to land. And I feel like I have quite a good track record of landing this quite well. It's just on this occasion, we were a little bit... This field looked so flat from above. Yes, Bailey, I'll definitely have to come and check out FlightZilla when they're on next time, for sure. Okay, cool. So let's see if we can get this thing started back up again then. So let's get the fuel valves on, get the magneto on. Throttle is up at 100%. Let's head out front here and give her a spin. There we go. Good track record. 1 out of 5. Exactly. In this aircraft, I feel like a good track record is... it has a slightly different meaning, I feel like it's fair to say. Christina, thank you very much for the follow, as well as Paul Nangle and Paul Davey. Thank you very much. Wilhelm as well, thank you very much for the follow over on Facebook. Much appreciated. Hope you're well and having a fantastic weekend. Welcome to the stream. All right. All right, ready, guys, to go again. We've not refueled, but I think we're going to be okay. We've got quite a decent amount of fuel left. So we should be good on that front. So let's do it, guys. Wrong keybind. Chocks away. And we have no ground control in this one, so this could end poorly. This hill does seem to want to go to the right a bit. So let's see how this goes. Let's get that tail wheel up off the ground. Oh dear, this is extremely poor. Oh, okay, this couldn't go any worse. We're going right towards the trees. I can't do anything about this, unfortunately. Okay, thankfully those trees are invisible. Just close your eyes for a second. Close your eyes for a second. Don't worry. Don't worry about it. Don't worry. We're up in the air. That's all that matters. All right. Oh dear, we're going the wrong way. But, let's just let... Oh dear. Oh dear, this is not good. Uh-oh. I can't quite keep her straight at the moment. Let's see if I can just rectify the situation. There we go. Okay, and we're set, I think. We're kind of going in the right way. I think so. Oh dear, this is not going well at all, is it, guys? We're just kind of... Oh dear. Oh no, that's not the right song. Alright, guys, let's do this thing. Adam, thank you very much, dude. I'm doing very well, thank you. I'm totally turned around. Where's the sun? There we go, okay. So we want to get that on our left hand side. Where's the sea? There it is, I think. I think I see it. Jose, welcome to the stream. Welcome to yourself in Brazil. Good to see you. Welcome to the chat. Alright, I think we're back on a straight course now. I think I've stabilized somewhat. Oh no, we're getting gusted again. Come on. Kind of, we're only just passing where we took off from. We took off down here. Progress! Progress! Ted, absolute pleasure, mate. Take it easy. Oh dear. Flying this thing with that music just adds so much more. It feels so relevant. Oh no, not again. Please. Please. Right, okay, let's see if we can at least get towards the coast. Right, we should be able to... I mean, hopefully the cliffs will be nicely rendered in for us this time, so we'll probably get a nice good view of them as we fly over this time. Beautiful. Oh dear, so much fun, so much fun. I need to focus up here. I'm getting far too twisted, of course. I'm just trying to fiddle on my other screen here. And every time I let go of the stick, it's just, it's not going well for me. All right. Getting somewhat stabilized here. I think. Right. Play the theme song of Those Magnificent Men and Their Flying Machine. I don't think I've ever heard that. Let's see. Let's just try and at least get ourselves going the right direction. It's just far too difficult to Google anything whilst flying this thing. This is good. Yes, this is definitely the theme song right here. All right, let's do that again. I'm probably gonna get my stream muted for a bit of this, but it's most definitely worth it. Did we land yet? Yeah, we already landed once. Yeah, we're going back now. We're going back to Calais. It's brilliant, isn't it, Brian? It's so fun. Oh dear. We need a shot of this guy. Oh dear. Oh, hang on. Definitely going off course doing this, but it's so worth it. Oh my. It's worth a watch. I will check it out, yeah, certainly. I'm surprised I'm actually managing to fly this in this camera angle. It just reveals even more how unstable this thing is in flight. What about a bit of this? Oh no, it's not playing. I'm definitely getting turned around here. This is, oh dear, hang on. Landing. No, we've already landed, Brian. We're just on our way back to Calais. We are currently just trying to... We're trying to leave Dover, but it's proving quite difficult. Yeah, we're just getting... we're just getting blown about a bit here. These are the cliffs of Dover just below us right here. You can kind of see... And yeah, we just try to head off towards Calais. It's it seems to be a lot more difficult trying to get off this side of the coast than this side of the channel than the other. Oh, I'm completely forgot about the camera there. Here we go, there's the cliffs below us, beautiful. Oh, they've... Oh no. What's happened? Have we gone too far along the... Because it's definitely rendered in down there. I think we've gone too far off this side, actually. I think we're quite a bit further away than what we wanted to be. Antonio, thank you very much for the follow. Hope you're doing well. Having a fantastic week. Welcome to the stream. Alright, I think I might just have to calm down with the copyright music right now, otherwise bad things could happen. Let's see if we can bank a little bit over more to the right and just bring ourselves around a bit so we can get a bit of a better view of the cliffs right here. I'm still here. I'm just going to turn the camera off for a minute. By Dover. I'll see you later. Been emotional. Very emotional and quite painful actually. Definitely think I pulled a muscle in my back after that crash. Or at least being afflicted with some minor whiplash. I think you can just about see France from here, actually. It's Oh no, that's not France. That's France over there in the far, far distance. This is just the sea. Basri, welcome to the chat from Australia. Hello, I hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome. How much horsepower? I believe this this engine has 25 horsepower. 25. What's my throttle percentage? Full throttle. It's all the way up. Couldn't be any higher. Oh no, we're getting turned around here. Oh no, the wind. Yeah, it's hopelessly underpowered. But hey ho, that's what you get when you put a old motorcycle engine in a plane. Engine sounds like it's gonna give way at any minute. Yeah, I mean, it's as you just saw on the way down, it is quite temperamental. Who would ever need more than 25 horsepower? Exactly. Exactly right. Nobody needs more than 25 horsepower. Oh, you missed the landing. Oh, that's a shame. If you actually go back on... If you go onto my YouTube channel, we're also streaming live on YouTube at the moment. So if you go onto YouTube... And you can actually rewind the video on YouTube if you wanted to go back and see it. But of course, the recordings will be up on Facebook afterwards as well. How long did it take to cross the channel? It doesn't actually take too long. I think the leg there only took us... It only took us like 40 minutes or so. Not too terribly long. Not as long as you would think, actually. But yeah, John, we're going to be definitely going to be attempting another landing back in Calais anyway. That should be a lot of fun. It's strange how the cliffs of Dover, they render so far out when we're on our way out, but on the way in, they just didn't want to render, did they? Yeah, we've just left Dover. You can see there the cliffs just in the background, Brandon. Wheel drag won't help. Yeah, I'm sure it won't. I mean, the drag from pretty much most of the components on this thing probably doesn't do it any favours. Let's see if we can get turned out of the sun, because that is certainly the wrong way. It's so difficult to actually tell when you're turning, though, when you don't have any point of reference. There we go, just a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. You're at those cliffs today. That's awesome, dude. Let's see. Let's just make sure this is recording this time. I don't know if it is, actually. Oh, we should be able to see the path. I'll make sure I screenshot it before we do the replay. Alright. I think we're kind of headed in the right direction. You can kind of just see France over there. I think the one of the issues we're going to have, though, coming into Calais is there's no real... I suppose there's no real landmarks you can look for. I know there's obviously the Channel Tunnel, but I don't know how well that's going to be rendered in the sim. So, let's just see how we get on here. We might just have to put it down in the general vicinity. Goodbye, Dover. Let's wave with the rudder. Give it a little wave. Doesn't matter too much by doing this because the rudder's it's relatively ineffective, so did you see a blurry eye in the sky? Yeah, I hope you're looking out for us. God, we need to get away from the sun. Stop gusting me. Slowly ease around. There we go. Probably a bit further, actually. There's Dover. Oh, it's off there to our right. The cliffs, they look pretty epic from over here. Looks pretty epic right there. Okay. Looking good. There's a fair few more clouds on the return journey, though, which is could be quite a hazardous. Oh dear. Could be fairly hazardous for us. Let's see how we get on. The texture work on this looks so So good. It looks incredible. You can see where, I guess, people have climbed up this side here and this side. Quite a challenging experience trying to keep up with this thing, not gonna lie. It require a lot of input. It's kind of a bit of a relief to actually take my hand off the joystick for a second. Quite ideal to have some actual proper rudder pedals for this, to be honest. All right, let's see what our progress is looking like. So Dover is a fairly distant memory. I'm still not seeing, I guess this is the coastline of France here, so I'd probably say we're about maybe about 40% of the way, potentially. So making pretty decent progress, I'd say. Honestly, looking forward to landing this thing. It's so much fun to land. So satisfying. Landing on a strip or just a piece of land, you see. Most likely will just be a piece of land somewhere. Most likely. I mean, we're trying to do it the 1909 way, right? So, you know, I feel like there probably wasn't too many dedicated places to land a plane back then. So, yeah, we're just going to kind of go for... I mean, I think it might be quite cool to attempt to try and land back in the same field that we set off from. That might be quite cool, but it might be a bit of a task to try and find it. But we'll see. I've got a rough idea of where it might have been. So we could try that. Normandy Beach. How far is that away from Calais? Is that... that's going to be a bit further along the coast, right? The trouble with the beaches as well in this sim is I'm not 100% sure how well they're going to be modeled. They might not actually be showing up as, you know, solid ground, if that makes sense. Silhouette though. Love it. Yeah, I think we'll try and aim for, I think, the field that we took off in. I think that's probably a good target to aim for, at least. I suppose it depends really how close we come to that target when we actually get over the coast, because we might have gone off track a little bit here. I mean, the cliffs are more or less, well, they're off to our right hand side. So, I mean, we might be good, actually. We might come in a little bit more over Calais and have to fly a bit west to get to where we started, but it's not going to be super, super far. Kamakshaya, welcome to the chat over on YouTube. I hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome. Oh, it's Arjo. Okay. Good to see you, dude. I hope you're doing well. It's been a little while. How you doing, dude? All right. There's the coastline. It's coming into view. It's getting closer. It's getting closer. Glad to hear it, Arjo, dude. Glad to hear it, man. Feel like we can probably say at this point that the French coast is closer than the English coast, I think. Did I bring toilet paper? No, I did not bring toilet paper, unfortunately. I'm doing very well, thank you, Arjo. Yeah, thanks for asking, dude. Yeah, I'm doing good. Yeah, I can't help but love this thing. I'm not sure I'm going to be flying the this variant too often after this, but definitely the gnome. The gnome is super satisfying. Turn on maximum wind to give us a headwind for the journey. If I turned the wind up on this thing, it would literally just blow over and fall out of the sky. Wish I could seal my cameras. Well, please don't do that. I like my cameras. Excuse me. She is certainly quite a handful. Yeah, I think if I had rudder pedals, it might be a little bit more manageable. But because I'm having to sort of twist on my joystick every time I want to put rudder input, because the spring is quite strong really in these joysticks, isn't it, for the Z axis? So that is quite tiring. Then All right. I can't quite make out Calais. I imagine it's somewhere behind these clouds. Oh, wait. Is that that lake? Is that the lake from earlier? Oh, no. There's quite a few lakes along there, isn't there? I'm not sure. I might aim for that lake, though. I feel like that's... I don't know. It feels like it could be the lake. You know, we used the lake to kind of orient ourselves, didn't we? So I feel like this might be... This might be the way. This might be the way. Been on a few fast crossings back to Heathrow from New York because of the headwinds, maybe 1 hour, 50 minutes less. Yeah, I've heard a lot about those. Never had a chance to experience them myself. But I know there's some pretty decent records set for having a good tailwind on the way back from New York is the positioning of the jet stream. Would love to be on one of those flights, to be honest. The ground speeds they get, I bet they're ridiculous, like 700 knots or something. Thank you very much, Arjo. Dude, it's coming along nicely. Yeah, ask away. I feel like we're not moving anymore. Oh yeah, it's frozen. I think it's because my gamepad is disconnected, so it's just gonna freeze for a second. How tall am I? I don't actually know the measurement off the top of my head. Somewhere around 5'11". Danny, thank you very much for the 50 stars. Much appreciated. Very generous. Thank you. I'm sorry the Facebook notifications today seem to be extremely either quiet or just not sounding. I'm not sure why that is. Just turn them up a bit. Maybe they'll be a bit more audible now. But yeah, Arjo, probably around 5'11"-ish, 5'10", something like that. I'm not sure exactly. Why do you ask? I put 4. Fair play. Not sure if I'm doing myself any favours here heading towards this lake, but I've got a good feeling about it. It just looks like it could be the right spot. Although there is a lot of clouds here kind of obstructing my vision. There could be a lake there, I couldn't be totally sure. Where are we going? We are going to Calais. So we've just done the channel crossing from Calais to Dover, and we're now doing the same in reverse. Oh, excuse me, guys. I can't stop yawning right now. It's a lot later than what I usually do in my streams, to be fair. How is your photo shoot going? I've not got any ongoing projects at the moment, unfortunately, but steady away. Unfortunately, we're still pretty much under lockdown in the UK, so I can't really do a lot of work right now. So it's a bit slow going. But Just keeping myself busy, learning how to fly planes, and entertaining you guys, hopefully. Oh dear, I can't see anything but the sun. We need to turn quite a lot right here. Thought we said we were going where nobody has gone before. I guess you're referring to the description on the Facebook post. Well, I mean, we were trying to say in that post was just a bit of a joke, really. I was just saying, if you cast your mind back to before this date, where Blériot did his original flight from Calais to Dover, then yeah, technically it would be technically it wouldn't be something someone's done before, but yeah, it's just a bit of a joke. We're from the UK too. Nice, dude. Nice. We get quite a lot of viewers from the UK. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. I mean, even if we have the vaccine over here in the UK, you're still not allowed to. We're still under like a lockdown situation where we can't travel, we can't do a whole lot of work. So, unfortunately, it still doesn't really make too much of a difference. Dave, welcome to the chat. Good to see you. What's the bomb type thing you have in the plane? As in, I believe you're talking to that, talking about that right there. That is, it's actually a flotation aid in case we have to ditch in the sea. Essex. I'm from the north, Mark, up near Leeds. I couldn't resist going back for Landing Mark 2. Well, you're tuning in at a pretty good time. We're actually almost there, to be honest. Actually not too far away. Tell you what I might do, though, is I might actually start trying to lose a bit of altitude here. And I think what I'm going to try and do this time is I'm going to try to not forget about the magneto and hopefully... I'm going to keep it in my view there, so I can see that I'm toggling it on and off. And hopefully I won't mess up this time. I'm going to leave the throttle in full this time, just because I think it gives me a little bit more leeway if I screw up. Leeds isn't north. Well, I mean, I suppose it means different things to different people, I suppose, doesn't it? But I don't think many people would say that Leeds is in the Midlands either, so... Dave, thank you very much for the follow. Welcome to the stream, buddy. Yeah, it's definitely helpful me having the magneto switch in my view here. Hang on, let me start the recorder again. I love how the front of the aircraft just drops down when you toggle it off. I bet that was quite nerve-wracking, actually, in the real thing. I bet it feels, I mean, you can feel it in your stomach. Second chance for a landing, I can't stop watching. Yes, indeed, dude, indeed. Hopefully we don't flip over this time. Two hours south from a Geordie lad. Yeah, very true, very true. It's also like, what, 5 hours away from London? So, I mean, it is what it is, isn't it? I think it's generally referred to as the north, roughly speaking. But, yeah, I mean, I'm not really too fussy. It's just generally how I refer to it. I suppose in Leeds as well, a lot of people generally refer to it as the North. Oh no, oh my god, I nearly forgot to toggle it back on then. Holy balls. Oh my god, I thought we'd ruined it again then. Oh no, look how low our fuel is getting. This could be interesting. Alright, I'm not sure if that's the lake that we saw previous. It might be actually, I can't really tell. I can't see any other lakes that look similar. I think this is the one, I think. Let's see. I want to get down a little bit lower so we can at least see the lay of the land a bit better. That is the lake. I think it is. So in that case, that means that we took off somewhere down. Was it this field? I'm not sure. I remember it being quite a distinctly long looking field, because that's what I was looking for. Alright, here we go, guys. Making our way down. Yeah, I'm not sure we're going to be able to find the original field that we took off in, but we'll give it our best shot. The aircraft was from a developer called Wing 42, they're actually in the chat. Well, I think they're still in the chat anyway, but yeah, highly recommend checking it out. It's super fun, super different to probably anything you've ever flown in a flight sim before. Yep, there they go. So if you click on their name, you'll probably be able to, it'll probably take you straight to their Facebook page. You can check it out or check out the website. Highly recommend. Damn, we must have had some serious altitude, because I feel like we're incredibly high up at the moment, even still. Above the clouds in a blurio. Absolutely incredible. I might just try bring the throttles back a teeny bit. No, I wonder if it was that field. I wonder if it's one of these down here. Because I feel like this area right here, this is possibly where the channel tunnel comes out, I think. It could be. Or that might be. I don't know, it's difficult to say. I mean, nevertheless, this field does look like a very decent place to land. But having said that, I feel like we weren't... That's that lake. I feel like we were over here somewhere. Actually, no, wait, was it... Was it this? It might have been this field right here. I think it could have been one of these. Or potentially this long one here. I think it could have been that. I think that could be a good candidate. Yeah, I think I'm going to aim for there. Make sure I don't lose the fields now. I think it's right there, isn't it? There's a lake. Yeah, it must be one of these. We can probably, if we go for that field there, that long one, we're going to be sort of landing into the wind with a little bit of a headwind, so that could work out pretty nice for us, actually. A lot better than last time, let's say. Hopefully I don't cut out the engine this time. It's very tense. You just gotta pay attention, really. The issue is, because I'm trying to stream to you guys and do this at the same time, it's so easy to just lose track of when I pressed it and how low the revs on the if you can even call it that, on the engine are before I cut it out, because you've got to kind of listen to that sound of the engine. You've got to kind of keep it so it's like spluttering is, I think, the only way to describe it. And we are about to go through this cloud here, but I think it's quite a thin cloud, so I don't think we're gonna have too many issues, hopefully. oh dear. I think I have a general idea of where we're going, so as long as we keep descending, we should just pop out the bottom of this cloud and hopefully... get a visual on where we're supposed to be going again. Pretty sure it's in this direction. Jack, thank you very much for the follow. Hope you're doing well and having a fantastic week. Welcome to the stream. Oh dear, we got turned around in that cloud big time, didn't we? Holy crap. We're actually facing the complete... Oh no. Oh no, I've done it again. Oh, I've done it again. This is a problem. All right, let me see if I can get this turn in then before we get too low. Oh no, guys. I've freaking done it again, haven't I? Dear, oh dear. Oh well. I mean, it's not the end of the world, I suppose, if the engine cuts out. It just means we're going to have less control over where we land. So, the wind's going to be coming roughly from that direction. So, I mean, we've still got quite a bit of height to lose. Yeah, I think we're okay. I mean, there's still, luckily, a lot of fields around here. And yeah, I mean, I was listening to the engines as much as I could do, but the issue is when I'm trying to talk on stream and I'm trying to do both those things at once, it's too easy to just slip up. It's too easy. But yeah, they are running out pretty rapid. Oh dear. Okay, we can still pull this off, I think. Let's see. Gogs, good afternoon. Welcome back to the chat. Good to see you again. I hope you're doing well. Yeah, just a little bit different. Unfortunately, we've just lost our engines. I make that sound like it's something that's actually gone wrong with the aircraft. It hasn't. It was entirely my own fault. But I think we should be good. I think, I mean, we've got plenty of fields in front of us, honestly. I'm still, no, I think we just carry on this course because the wind is coming from this direction, isn't it? So if we carry on this course here, then we're going to have a bit of a headwind and we should at least be able to, I think we're definitely going to touch down. I don't know. Possibly over here, potentially. And it looks like it slopes up a little bit there, so that might aid us in slowing down when we land. Although, yeah, let's see how it goes, guys. Let's see how it goes. Matchstick racing. Yeah, I suppose it's a little bit in that realm. Yo, Leon, thank you very much for the 100 stars. Very, very kind, as always, dude. Appreciate that, man. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. Oh, you can hear that wind blowing as well. It sounds so cool. I'm going to turn the music down a bit and turn the sim up so you guys can hear all the sort of cool sounds going on from up here. The sound of that propeller is, I don't know, I feel like, because I've flown this on quite a few occasions where I've actually ended up in this scenario, that sound is kind of, it's a little bit nerve-wracking for me, I think, because I know I don't have too much control anymore. You get a sports badge tomorrow for staying on Facebook. Yeah, dude. I mean, I think we're at least going to continue with the multi-streaming for the foreseeable, at least. That's what we're doing today. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch. So yeah, for the foreseeable, we will. All right, cool. We are getting quite low down now. Thankfully, we've cleared that river. We've got a nice little strip off to our left there, that big green field, which is looking pretty tasty for a landing. You can hear the prop spinning down now. I've pretty much lost quite a lot of control here, I feel like. There we go. Let's just tease around. Let's tease around a bit. I'm feeling pretty confident about this landing, I'm not going to lie, guys. This is looking a bit more promising than in Dover. We might end up crossing this, flying across this road. Nah, I think we're going to clear the road, actually. All right, here we go, guys. Look at that, beautifully over the road. And flaring. There we go. Like a glove. Oh my god. Fantastic. Let's just make sure she doesn't tip over when we let go of the back pressure on the stick. All right, chocks on, chocks on. Oh, beautiful. Absolutely fantastic. Absolutely. Like butter, that. 167 feet per minute. Professional. That was, yeah, that was certainly an improvement. That was an improvement, wasn't it? I'm happy with that. Nice flat, this field as well, so we didn't even roll far, hardly. Look at that. Fantastic. Love it. Beautiful. It's quite a nice shot right here as well, isn't it? Oops. There we go. All right. Let's see if we can bring up the... Oh, no, we can't. It's not bloody recorded it again. Oh, well. Never mind. But we are more or less where we wanted to be. Honestly, I don't think we're far away from the field where we originally took off from. I mean, I couldn't tell you exactly where that field is, but I feel like we're not too far away. Beautiful. Thank you very much, guys. Let's watch that again on the replay mode. What's the plane modelled on? In what respect, Gogs? It's this plane in particular. I mean, it is a replica of the Blériot 11. Nathan, thank you very much for the follow. Hope you're well and having a fantastic week. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, it's Blériot 11, Gogs. Wow, it's so quiet up here with the engine off. It looks a bit freaky without the without the pilot there. All right, let's fast forward a bit. Wouldn't fancy running it for real life. I don't think a lot of people would. I'm not. I don't blame you at all there. Here we are. So this, where did we land? We ended up, was it this field we ended up in? Yeah, it was, wasn't it? I think there's the road. Yeah, let's see this again. Too many people died flying this thing, yeah. Yeah, sadly, but... yeah, I mean, honestly, if I had a choice to fly in it now, I think that's probably going to be a no from me. All right, let's see this touchdown one more time. See the I was kind of holding in quite a bit of well, not quite a bit, but I was holding the elevator for quite a long time as I came in here, because I wanted to try and clear this road here. But yeah, those wheels, they are like bike wheels, aren't they? Look at that, very, very thin. All right, here we go. Here's a touchdown. Oh. Oh my God. That was very solid. That was pretty solid, that. I feel like we landed on like all four wheels at exactly the same time. Sorry, not all four wheels, all three. Which is just brilliant, really. That's what you want, right? Beautiful. That was, yeah, I'm really happy with that. That was slick. Even though the engine died on us. Oh, I love it. So satisfying. Brilliant. And I was keeping full elevator in as we as I touched down, because I was scared that I might flip over again. Oh dear. But we landed with, I mean, let's see, I can bring up the map now because we're here. So the wind is coming from, well, southeastish. So we landed with mostly a headwind component. We had a slight bit of a crosswind component, I suppose, from the right. But I feel like, yeah, we managed to pull that off quite well. Beautiful. I'm very happy with that. We've been from Calais to Dover and back in the Blériot 11. Not only have we recreated history one time, but we've actually created history by flying back. Beautiful. Beautiful. Good practice. The elevator also generates lift in this aircraft, which is an odd thing to handle. Yeah, I've noticed that indeed. Yeah, you can definitely feel that when you're in flight. Yeah. But yeah, I'm pretty pleased with that. I mean, let's just say when we flipped over in Dover, that was for historical accuracy. But yeah, I'm pretty pleased with that. I hope you guys enjoyed as well. It was definitely a lot of fun for me. But I think that's unfortunately all I've got time for today. So thank you all for tuning in. Hope you guys have enjoyed. And yeah, that's going to be all from me. So thank you very much, everybody. Wing42, of course, for popping by. Appreciate you dropping in. And I hope you enjoyed. Gogs, thank you very much for tuning in, as always. Who else we've got? Leon, of course, Alistair, Dave, Milhale, thank you very much, Robbie, Andrew, Frederick, I don't think I can scroll back any further, unfortunately, but thank you very much, everybody, for tuning in. If you're watching, I hope you've enjoyed. Nathan as well, thank you very much for following, Jack as well, Christina, Paul, Philbert Flies, of course, Wilhelm, Bailey, and everybody else who dropped in from FlightZilla's stream. Thank you very much. Hope you guys have enjoyed. And yeah, I will catch you. Oh, God, that's loud. I will catch you in the next one. Next stream will be announced tomorrow. I'm not sure when it will be exactly. Tuesday at the latest. I might try and squeeze one in tomorrow if I've got time. Otherwise, I'll see you guys on Tuesday. So, enjoy the rest of your evening, guys. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.